What's been on your mind, Chris? The fight on Rigel 7?
Shouldn't it be? My own yeoman and two others dead, 7 injured.
Was there anything you personally could have done to prevent it?
Oh, I should have smelled trouble when I saw the swords in the armor. Instead of that, I let myself get trapped in that deserted fortress and attacked by one of their warriors.
Oh, Chris, you set standards for yourself no one could meet. You treat everyone on board like a human being except yourself. Well, now you're tired and you...
You bet I'm tired. You bet. I'm tired of being responsible for 203 lives, and I'm tired of deciding which mission is too risky and which isn't, and who's going on the landing party and who doesn't, and who lives, and who dies.
To James T. Kirk, captain of the Enterprise.
Thank you, Doctor.
That's one of your better prescriptions.
Simple, but effective.
The other one, all I ask is a tall ship.
It's a line from a poem, a very old poem, isn't it?
20th century Earth. All I ask is a tall ship and a star to steer by. You could feel the wind at your back in those days. The sounds of the sea beneath you. And even if you take away the wind and the water, it's still the same. The ship is yours. You can feel her. And the stars are still there, Bones.
Captain Kirk, to the bridge, please. Captain Kirk.
Starn. She is yours. After a time, you may find that having is not so pleasing a thing, after all, as wanting. It is not logical, but it is often true.
I wish I were in a long sea voyage somewhere. Not too much deck tennis, no frantic dancing, and no responsibility. Why me? I look around that bridge. I see the men waiting for me to make the next move. And Bones, what if I'm wrong?
Captain, I don't really expect an answer. But I've got one.
Something I seldom say to a customer, Jim. In this galaxy, there's a mathematical probability of 3 million Earth-type planets. And in all of the universe, 3 million galaxies like this. And in all of that, and perhaps more, only one of each of us. Don't destroy the one named Kirk. Well, that's the second time man's been thrown out of paradise.
No, Bones. This time we walked out on our own. Maybe we weren't meant for paradise. Maybe we were meant to fight our way through, struggle, claw our way up, scratch for every inch of the way. Maybe we can't stroll to the music of the lute. We must march to the sound of drums.
Poetry, Captain.
We have only just discovered that you do not understand all this. These experiences were intended to amuse you.
Amuse? That's your word, what we've been through?
But none of this is permanent. Here you have to only imagine your fondest wishes, either old ones which you wish to relive or new ones, anything at all. Battle, fear, love, triumph. Anything that pleases you can be made to happen.
The term is amusement park.
Of course.
An old Earth name for a place where people could go to see and do all sorts of fascinating things.
This entire planet was constructed for our race of people. To come and play.
Play? As advanced as you obviously are. Can you still play?
Yes, play, Mr. Sulu. More complex the mind, the greater the need for the simplicity of play.
Exactly, Captain. How very perceptive of you.
Captain, why did you feel the attacking ships would not fire when they saw the Enterprise apparently vulnerable? Logically, that is the sort of trap M5 should have set for them.
I wasn't sure. Any other commander would have simply followed orders and destroyed us. But I knew Bob Wesley. I gambled on his humanity.
Bridge. His logical selection was compassion.
Compassion? That's the one thing no machine ever had. Maybe it's the one thing that keeps men ahead of them. Care to debate that spot?
No, Doctor. I simply maintain that computers are more efficient than human beings, not better.
Excuse me, Captain Kirk.
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Scott.
What a charming negress. Oh, forgive me, my dear. I know that in my time some use that term as a description of property.
But why should I object to that term, sir? You see, in our century, we've learned not to fear words.
May I present our communications officer, Lieutenant Uhura?
The foolishness of my century had me apologizing where no offense was given.
We've each learned to be delighted with what we are.
Captain, I'm beginning to understand why you Earthmen enjoy gambling. No matter how carefully one computes the odds of success, there is still a certain exhilaration in the risk.
Very good, Spock. We may make a human of you yet.
I hope not. Captain, I never will understand humans. How could a man as brilliant, a mind as logical as John Gill's, have made such a fatal error?
You drew the wrong conclusion from history, I think. The problem with the Nazis wasn't simply that their leaders were evil, psychotic men. They were. But the main problem, I think, was the leader principle.
What he's saying, Spock, is that a man holds that much power, even with the best intentions, just can't resist the urge to play God.
Thank you, Doctor. I was able to gather the meaning.
It also proves another saying. Absolute power corrupts absolutely. Darn clever, these Earthmen, wouldn't you say?
Yes. Earthmen like Ramses, Alexander, Caesar, Napoleon, Hitler, Lee Kuan. Your whole Earth history is made up of men seeking absolute power.
Now, Spock, you obviously don't...
Obviously, Doctor, you failed to accept...
Gentlemen, we've just been through one civil war. Let's not start another. Chekhov, take us out of orbit, warp factor 2, and hurry.